Hello students, welcome to the session. Today I am going to present regarding the femoral triangle. So femoral triangle, it's a triangle that is seen in the upper part of the thigh. So it comes under deep structures of the thigh, because covering this femoral triangle you will be having the muscles of the anterior compartment of the thigh. So femoral triangle is an inverted triangle that is seen in the upper part of the thigh. Why I am telling it is inverted triangle means it is having the base that is related to the inguinal ligament. So triangular depression below the inguinal ligament. To tell about inguinal ligament, it is a ligament that is attached from anterior superior iliac spine laterally to the pubic tubercle medially. So that forms the base of the femoral triangle. So inguinal ligament forms the base of the femoral triangle. While it comes to the apex of the femoral triangle, that is directed lower, where you see the meeting point of sartorius muscle with adductor longus muscle. So apex is directed downwards, where you see the meeting point of sartorius and adductor longus muscle. So you can see here, when I tell the boundary, so apex is directed below, that is the meeting point of sartorius and adductor longus. Or you can also tell that lateral boundary of the femoral triangle is formed by the medial border of sartorius, whereas the medial boundary of femoral triangle is formed by the medial border of adductor longus muscle. Base is directed above and it is formed by inguinal ligament. Coming to the roof relations of femoral triangle, it is the skin, superficial fascia, where you can find the cutaneous nerves and also the saphenous veins draining to the femoral vein after piercing the saphenous opening. So coming to the floor and the contents of the femoral triangle, so floor relations comes from lateral to medial. You have iliopsoas muscle, iliopsoas, then pectineus, then adductor longus itself. Iliopsoas, pectineus and adductor longus itself. Okay, so just over the iliopsoas you are finding the content, lateral most content of the femoral triangle, that is femoral nerve with its branches. Then in between the iliopsoas and pectineus, like, you will find the femoral artery, which is the middle content of the femoral triangle, and medial most content is the femoral vein. So laterally it is the femoral nerve, then the center, it is the femoral artery, and medially you find the femoral vein with its some tributaries, femoral vein with its tributaries. Okay, so these are the three main contents of the femoral triangle. So one more thing what you can appreciate in the slide is, just beneath the inguinal ligament you are seeing these three main structures that are passing in the femoral triangle, and you can appreciate that the lateral most content is the femoral nerve, and you see the femoral vessels which are enclosed by the femoral sheath. Okay, so only it's appearing like lightish, so that is because of the covering of the femoral sheath. Now what is this femoral sheath? So it is the extension of the fascia of the abdomen, that is transversalis fascia and fascia iliaca, that passes beneath the inguinal ligament. So anterior layer of the femoral sheath is formed by fascia transversalis, whereas the posterior layer of femoral sheath is formed by fascia iliaca. So this extensions of the fascia with the abdomen is only till 2.5 centimeters distal to the inguinal ligament. The femoral vessels are covered by femoral sheath. Just to show you the femoral sheath formation, anterior layer by fascia transversalis and posterior layer is by fascia iliaca. The femoral nerve is not the content of femoral sheath, because you see that femoral nerve is passing behind the fascia iliaca and then passing below the inguinal ligament and appearing in the femoral triangle. So femoral nerve is not the content of femoral sheath. Coming to the femoral sheath a little, that is, it is divided into three compartments. So here now the lateral compartment structure content is femoral artery, the middle or intermediate compartment goes for femoral vein, and the medial most compartment is the femoral canal, where you can only see the lymph nodes. So you can see there The lateral most compartment is for femoral artery, middle or intermediate compartment is for femoral vein, and the medial most compartment is called as femoral canal. Not important structures are present there, but the lymphatic, so lymph nodes are present there. And what is femoral ring? So it is that upper ring that is formed of the femoral canal itself. It's called as femoral ring with the lymph nodes. So that is called as femoral canal, and the upper ring is called as femoral ring. So what is the importance of this like femoral ring? In the sense, the applied aspects of that is, you will see the hernia taking place actually through this medial most compartment of the femoral canal as such. So that is hernia, in the sense it is the abnormal protrusion of the abdominal contents into the upper regions of the thigh, and it is through this femoral canal you see the femoral hernia. Structures that are piercing the femoral sheath is the important structure, that is great or long saphenous vein. It pierces the sheath and it is draining to the femoral vein. Another structure is femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve, even that pierces the femoral sheath anterior wall. So femoral hernia, it is like more common in case of females when compared to males. That is because of the lesser dimension of the femoral vessels in case of females, and also females have a wider or greater pelvis when compared to males. So that is why females commonly are subjected to femoral hernia at the weakened place, that is femoral canal. Thank you.